I have to apologize for my overly floral look this morning. That's fantastic. David. I just came right from another film where it was appropriate, and now I was going to wear something.
You're going to wear a cop uniform.
Yeah, I was going to wear a cop uniform. Right, yeah. Exactly. You read my mind. And for End of Watch, which I loved, what a fantastic, surprising film. Congratulations.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
It was very, very moving, very well acted, and it, you know.
It's impactful.
Yeah, that's it. That's a good word. It's exactly what it is. So you did one. Did you wrote this too?
I wrote it. I wrote the script.
Wow.
6 days.
Just 6 days?
Exploded out of me. But I've written a lot of scripts. I know how to write scripts. I know how to write movies.
All right. Okay.
Written a lot of cop movies. So it's very familiar territory to me. And a friend of mine suggested, you need to write another cop movie. And I'm like, no, I don't, because I'm getting pigeonholed here.
Right.
And
Training Day.
Training Day and all this other stuff. And you know, I got this inspiration. A buddy of mine who's a cop had shot a bunch of videos on the job. And he showed me this sort of highlights reel of law enforcement, and it's stuff you ain't seeing on cops, that's for sure. And it was riveting. I mean, it was riveting, and it ranged from hilarious to heinous.
Wow.
And I'm like, man, you know, that would be a fantastic technique to tell a story with.
Which you did.
Which I did.
And your movie does go from hilarious to heinous. Now that you bring it up, I mean, but what you're showing is you're showing good cops for change,
exactly.
Which I was so happy to see.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, the corrupt cop, we've sort of seen every iteration of that year after year after year. And the truth of the matter is, it's good guys, and they're doing a good job, and they believe in the mission, they believe in the work, they're there to help people. And that's the big twist, is they're the good guys.
Yeah, and they have a wonderful rapport, two lead actors.
Yeah, it's the ultimate buddy movie, you know?
Yeah.
There's just this fantastic chemistry.
And yes.
They make it seem effortless and easy and natural when behind the scenes there's an incredible amount of work that went in that.
Yeah, because they seem like they'd been driving around in that car in L.A. for years.
For years.
And there was this wonderful... Well, it's a relationship.
Exactly. And it's cool because you get to see, you know, like for the women out there, they get to see what guys are really saying about them when they're not around.
Mm.
And it's not as bad as you think. That's the big secret. We're like you. We talk about our relationships and how to make them better and what's going wrong. Surprise.
And you see their family life.
Yes.
And it's all very, you know, relatable.
Yep. Yes. It's just universal things.
Universal,
You forget that they're cops, and the relationship is so believable and so strong that it just goes front and center, and everything else kind of falls away. And I think the best scenes in the movie are two guys in a car talking.
Mm-hmm. I know, that was like riveting to me.
Yeah.
I was like, wow, I'm so involved with them, you know.
Yeah, and I'm
and then suddenly violence out of the blue happens.
And then violence happens like a lightning bolt out of the sky, which is how it really happens, you know. And it can be a dead quiet shift and nothing's going on, and the next thing you know, they're in a gunfight, you know. And all these things in the movie have happened or are happening now.
Well, it's the end for our End of Watch interview.
Okay.
I'm sorry to say, David Ayer, very, very nice to meet you.
Thank you.
I know you're going to have continued success in whatever you do. This is just an excellent, excellent piece of work, David.
Thank you. Appreciate that.